Hi there and welcome to another session of accounting with me Vishwanath sir for the 11th standard. We are with introduction of accounting revision part of it where we last compared the difference between bookkeeping and accounting. So today we shall take up some topics more further where we shall discuss accountancy and accounting and correlate certain things which come in the way. Fine. Accountancy is a systematic knowledge of accounting. Okay, so what is accountancy? It's a systematic knowledge of accounting. It explains how to deal with the various aspects of accounting. It educates us how to maintain the books, how to summarize the accounting information and communicate it to the proper users. In the words of Kohler, accountancy refers to the entire body of theory and practice of accounting. So just repeating again, accountancy is a systematic knowledge of accounting. It explains how to deal with the various aspects of accounting. It educates us how to maintain the books and how to summarize the accounting information and communicate it to the users. In the words of Kohler, accountancy refers to the entire body of theory and practice of accounting. Now, let us come to know what is accounting and accountancy. Accountancy is a knowledge where accounting is a process. Okay, it is a process or action. Accounting process is carried out on the basis of certain rules which are set and framed by accountancy. Thus, accountancy is knowledge of accounting and accounting is an application of accountancy. So remember, accounting is an application, it is a process or action. Now we come to the term which is known as accounting information. Okay, accounting information is so very vital for all of us, for all the organizations, for all the business firms, for the sole proprietors, for the partnership firms, for the non-profit organizations and even the cooperatives. Accounting information is a service activity. Its functions provides qualitative information, primarily financial in nature, about economic entities that is intended to be useful in making economic decisions. So we come to one very clear conclusion that there are economic transactions which are there, there are financial transactions which are there, which take place. As information system, accounting collects financial data, records it in the books of accounts, classifies it, summarizes it to produce financial information that is communicated to the users. Accounting begins where identification of transactions of financial nature and ends with the preparation of financial statements. Okay, so each step in the process of accounting generates information. Generation of information is not an end itself. It is a way to facilitate the communication of information to the users of the accounting information. Okay, so let us now go through the types of accounting information. The accounting information refers to the financial statement generated through the process of bookkeeping, because we keep the books and the records in the correct place and then we arrive at certain decision. So the financial statements which we make, first is the income statement where we have the trading and the profit and loss account. It is also known as the income statement, while as we have the balance sheet which is known as a position statement. This information is made available to us in regard to the information relating to the profit or surplus, information relating to the financial position and information relating to the cash flow. So these are very important informations. Now let us talk about the information relating to profit or surplus. This is the income statement which shows the expenses and the income. If the income is greater than the expenses, then automatically it is a profit, because it is your income is more than your expenses. In this, the firm prepares a trading account, then it prepares a profit and loss account, then it prepares, of course, a balance sheet, but we are talking about the profit or surplus. So first, the trading will give you the gross profit or the gross loss. If your incomes in your manufacturing stage or in your factory stage is more, automatically it is a gross profit, because your income is more than your expenses. Then if your expenses, your factory expenses or the cost of goods consumed is more, then it is a loss. From here we transfer this gross profit to the profit and loss account. So basically these are a list of administrative and management expenses and incomes which takes place. And if your income along with gross profit is greater than your expenses, the profit which you make is known as a net profit. Vice versa, if your debit side, that is your expenses, are greater than your credit side, which is your income, then it is a net loss. Okay, so we learn the terms gross profit and gross loss. Gross profit is when your trading account credit side is greater than the debit side. That means the trading account credit side means the income of the trading side, and the debit side means the expenses of the trading account. So when you find out the difference, if your income is more than your expenses, it is a gross profit. Vice versa, if your expenses are more than your income, it is a gross loss. This is transferred to the profit and loss account. And if the profit and losses account credit side, that is the income side, is more than the expense side, then it is a net profit. And vice versa, if the expense side, that is greater, that is the debit side, is greater than the credit side, which is the income side, then it is a net loss. So this is where your information relating to profit or loss is there. Then we have information related to the financial position, and this can be got by a statement which is known as your balance sheet. It's also known as a position statement. It has liabilities on the left hand side and assets on the right hand side. Okay, that is known as a horizontal format. Otherwise, the company format is a vertical format. But right now, let's not talk about the company balance sheet. We are talking about the sole proprietor and the partnership final accounts. Okay, so the information related to the financial position, that is a balance sheet. On the left hand side there is liabilities, on the right hand side there is assets. Liabilities are basically what we owe to the others if we have taken a loan or something, while as assets is what we own and what others owe us. Okay, so this is the financial position, and your financial position, your liabilities should be equal to your assets. Then we have got information regarding the cash flow. Now your cash flow is divided into two parts, inflow and outflow. Okay, and there are various inflow activities and outflow activities. There is investing activities, there is operating activities, there is financial activities. So from this, what is the inflow, what is the outflow is very important, and this also serves as one of the verifying accounts in the process of accounting. Okay, so the type of accounting information which we did is related to profit or loss, it is related to financial position, and it is related to the information about the cash flow. Okay, from here onwards I shift to what is known as a qualitative characteristics of accounting information. Number one, it has to be reliable. Okay, accounting information must be reliable. The reliability of information means it is verifiable, free from bias and material error. So it should be reliable. That means it should possess the property of reliability. Second is relevance. Accounting information must be relevant to the users. The information is relevant if it meets the use, if it meets the needs of the users in the decision making process. Okay, finally, understandability. Understandability means that the information provided through the financial statement must be presented in a manner the users are able to understand. Okay, so these are some of the qualitative characteristics of the accounting information. Also, comparability of two firms is very important. You have the intra-firm comparison and the inter-firm comparison. So the qualitative aspects of accounting information are as follows. Reliability, that means anytime when you check, it should be the same. Relevance, to the point. Understandability, whenever it is presented, people should understand. And finally, you have got comparative study. Okay, the comparative or comparability is also very important, that the user should be able to compare the accounting information with the other information. Okay, so what we did today was basically what was accountancy, what is accountancy and accounting, what is the types of accounting information, and finally we did the qualitative characteristics of accounting information. Please go through all these points thoroughly because it will be very useful for you. Thank you so much. This is Vishwanath sir signing off.